Father, I thank you for this wonderful occasion this afternoon with Mackenzie and Jesse at home. Coming together to gather about your lives together. And Lord, I pray that your spirit, your presence will be in this place today, God. That every word that is said, every vow that is made of glory, will come from the deepest part of their hearts and carry them for the rest of their lives. And may you be honored in this ceremony, I pray. In Jesus' name, amen. Please be seated. Marriage is a sacred institution as the basis of human society. It should be held in high honor among all men and women. For you are assembled here in the presence of God to join this man and this woman in holy marriage, which is instituted of God, regulated by His commandments, and blessed by our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us therefore remember that God has established and sanctified marriage for the welfare and for the happiness of mankind. Who is this woman to be married?
Starts with the meeting of vows and giving of hearts. two lives unite as one. What God hath brought together on this earth can't be undone. Vows of love and loyalty seal the light that two will start. With this special bond draws closer two minds, two souls, one heart. How good it can be when love's dream do come true. It's just the beginning when you say, I do. For their love is in the open for all the world to see. For God has blessed this couple's love for all eternity.
And hold me close. together forever. I thank God for your love.
Our Savior has declared that a man shall leave his father and his mother and cleave unto his wife. And by his apostles, he has instructed those who enter into this relationship to cherish a mutual esteem and love, to bear with each other's infirmities and weaknesses, to comfort each other in sickness, trouble, and sorrow, in honesty and industry to provide for each other and for their household, in temporal things to pray for and to encourage each other, in things pertaining to God, and to live together as heirs of His grace. The Bible teaches us that marriage was established in heaven by the divine wisdom and kindness of God, who said, "It is not good that man should be alone. I will make a helpmate for him." And he again said, "The two shall become one." In creation, Adam the man was first formed. Then the woman Eve, say the scriptures, that the woman might be for the man, setting forth the humility, the modesty, and gentleness that should characterize her kind. Yet man, in being made last of all of God's creatures, was set forth as the best and most excellent of God's creative works. So Eve, being made after Adam and out of him, sets an honor upon the woman as being the glory of the man. If the man is the head, she is the crown. She is the crown to her husband. The man was thus refined, but the woman was doubly refined, one step further from the earth. In being created from man or out of man, she was not out of his head to dominate or to be over him, nor out of his feet to be under him or trampled upon by him, but out of his side to be equal with him, from under his arm to be protected by him, and near to his heart to be loved by him. And the Holy Scripture set before you the love of Christ for his church as an example of your devotion. And you are not left without guidance concerning the meaning of that love. These are the words of the Apostle Paul. And if these words be remembered, they will guide you for the rest of your lives. Listen to this. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous, nor is it boastful. It is not arrogant, nor is it rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. As your union is to be broken only by death, it becomes you to consider the duties that you solemnly assume this day. And if these be remembered and faithfully discharged, they will add to the happiness of this life, dividing its inevitable sorrows and doubling all of its blessedness. It is the duty of the husband to provide support for his wife, to shelter her from danger, and to cherish her. It being the command of God's word that husbands love their wives, even as Christ loved the church and gave his own life for her. It is the duty of the wife to reverence her husband and to put on the ornament of a gentle and loving spirit, which is in God's sight an ornament of great price. It is the duty of both to delight each in the company of the other, to remember that in interest and in recognition, as in affection, you are henceforth one in my body. Mackenzie, do you solemnly agree before God and these witnesses to take this woman to be your lawful wedded wife, to love and respect her, honor and cherish her, in health and in sickness, in prosperity and in adversity, and leave all others to keep yourself only unto her, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Just in that, do you in my care solemnly agree to receive this man as your lawful wedded husband, to love and respect him, and to live with him in all faith and tenderness, in health and in sickness, in prosperity and in adversity, and leading all others to keep yourself only unto him, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
If you please join me and repeat after me. I, Mackenzie, take you, Jessenette.
I, Mackenzie, take you, Jessenette.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
And I do promise.
And I do promise.
Before God and these witnesses.
Before God and these witnesses.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Jessenette, you repeat that to me. I, Jessenette, take you, Mackenzie.
I, Jessenette, take you, Mackenzie.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
And I do promise.
And I do promise.
Before God and these witnesses.
Before God and these witnesses.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
To be a loving and faithful wife.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we shall live.
Mackenzie, what token do you give and pledge that you will faithfully perform these vows?
I have a ring.
If I could have the ring, please. You have selected this ring to be a token of your marriage covenant. It is made of gold, which is a type of that which is least tarnished and most enduring. The ring is an endless circle until broken by some outside force. That is a symbol of the unbroken purity and endlessness of your love. So every time you look at this ring, this represents your life together until the end of your days. If you place it on Jessenette's finger, repeat after me. This ring I give to you.
This ring I give to you.
In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of our constant faith.
Of our constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
If I can have the other ring, please. Jessenette, if you would take this and place it on Mackenzie's finger, please, and repeat after me. This ring I give to you.
This ring I give to you.
In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of our constant faith.
Of our constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
Okay, place it on this finger, please. The Kennedy and Jesse that you have to lay before your separate lives together. We are two separate bottles of sand that symbolize your separate lives, separate families, separate set of friends. They represent all that you are and that all you'll ever be as an individual. They also represent your lives prior to today. And as these two containers of sand are poured into the third container, the individual containers of sand will no longer exist, but will be joined together as one. And just as these grains of sand can never be separated and poured it again into the individual containers, so will your marriage ever be. So if you can take the sand, please, as you mingle, the symbol of mingling your lives together. Yes, just together. By the authority committed unto me as a minister of the gospel, I declare that Mackenzie and Jessenette are now husband and wife. You may kiss your bride. I now present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Mackenzie Pierre Francois.
This morning.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Cute.